just felt him touch me when I was a little boy. I felt him grab my heart. And I stood there and I was like 5 or 6 years old and I'm bawling my eyes out. And I was like looking around like, why am I crying? I don't understand this. I don't understand why I'm crying. You see, and then I was raised in a Christian home, but I got away from it like I told you. Until I laid back down on my face when I was probably 18, 19, 20 years old in that range. I laid on my face and said, Jesus, all of my life is yours. I've been chasing all these things. See, I didn't know it. I thought I was living my best life. I thought I was doing all these crazy things, but all it led to me was depression. I was depressed sitting there in my college house. I was depressed. I laid on my face and I said, this is so empty. If this is all I'm chasing, if being a Division I quarterback and doing this and doing that, hanging out with those people, people knew their names and all that, if that's what I'm chasing, if this is all that it is, this life is terrible. Like, this is so empty. This is so broken that I want nothing to do with it. I laid on my face and said, Jesus, you can have all of me at all moments, and I will always obey you. I will always follow you. And if I don't, correct me, because I'm always trying to get what you have for me. What Jesus has for you is better than anything you've ever dreamed of for yourself. What Jesus has for you is better than anything you've ever planned for yourself. See, the route that I was going led my friend at the time to say, I want nothing to do with you. That friend is now my wife, and we have 3 beautiful boys. You see, Jesus is best for me was a wife that I should have never had. Jesus's best for me was 3 little boys that I get to love dearly and cherish. Every single day I wake up and I get to see their face. The joy that I have in my heart is a reminder from God every single day that he loves me, that he would give me them, that he would give me the worst sinner of them all. I didn't care about not one person except pleasing my flesh, that he would give me those 3 little boys and that wife to look at every single day. It's a reminder every day of how much God loves me. Some of you have things in your life where you're like, man, he must really love me. Wow, God must really love me if he gave me A, B, and C. Let me tell you this. Some of us don't have the best backgrounds either. But if you would just stay at the feet of Jesus and be there when he shows up, I promise it would change your life forever. I promise you. Right now, I'm asking the worship team to come up here and just start playing just a little bit. Tickle the ivories a little bit. I'm not going to sing. I told you that at the beginning. Yeah, praise God. Amen. Amen, Mikey. I feel you. Let's learn from these people. Is that all right? Can we learn from them? Can we learn from these foolish girls? You see, maybe you're coming here today and you're empty inside. Maybe you have nothing to offer. Maybe you literally have nothing left in the tank. I don't know about you, but I need a touch right now in my life from God more than you would know. I can stand up here and be strong and all of those things, man. I need God to show up to do something that only he can do. Things that I've worked on in my own strength and my own might, and guess where it led me? Back to his feet saying, God, I try it. You got to do it. You see, recently I was going through something and I was fighting these battles. I kept fighting these battles and fighting and fighting and fighting and trying to do it myself because it wasn't the truth. Man, I'm all about the truth. The truth has to be told. The truth has to be what everyone knows. How many of y'all know that the world doesn't care about the truth? You see, I would fight, and then God told me in prayer one day, he said, why are you fighting battles that I have already won? There are battles in your life that God has already won. Your children are already on their way home. You just don't see it yet. The walls are still up. All you've got to do is obey. There are things happening in your heart right now that God needs to show up. He's already here, and he's already showing up, and he wants to fix that for you, but all you've got to do is obey. Just like these girls, man, the biggest mistake that they made was leaving the feet of Jesus. Let me tell you this. I am not by any means trying to scare you. I'm just trying to make sure that you know how serious this is. Is that all right? See, there was my buddy was a musician and he was playing and this kid came up to him after his show. And the kid came up to him and he said, hey, sir, you know, great show and all that. And then my buddy felt in his heart, like, this kid needs to know Jesus. So he told him, I told him the gospel and I prayed with him. And the guy said, man, that's not for me. I'm my own God. You see, maybe you don't take it to that extreme and think you're your own God, but are you serving yourself or are you serving your Creator? You see, that kid that day on his way home died in a car accident. The seriousness that he is going to stand before God, I really hope in his car he just started crying and accepted Christ. I really do. But the seriousness is that the fact is that he stood before God literally 10 minutes after he heard the gospel. I'm not trying to scare you at all. I know that's a weird story and that's tough, but I'm just trying to tell you how serious this life is. I'm just trying to paint a picture for you that now is the time. Stop leaving the feet of Jesus. Stop leaving his feet because it's laughed at, ridiculed, and mocked by the outside looking in. Stop leaving his feet and just stay planted there. You may have nothing to give him. Maybe you have nothing to offer except for yourself. And let me tell you, that is all that he needs. He took a little kid out of Fresno, California, of all places, with allergies and stuff. The dust there is terrible. He took a little kid out of Fresno, California, made him a professional athlete, but most importantly said, I'm going to make this one and he's going to obey me. Now I get to stand on stages and not care what anybody has to say and tell them the truth about life, because I've lived the other way. And I live every single day with complete joy in my heart, even the hard times. Even when, as soon as I turn the news on, oh, Derek Carr's getting traded. What? Clearly you don't know what I know, but am I? Like, hey, what's going on? You see, my whole life is on TV and all those kind of things. My biggest fault, my missteps, my biggest successes. But let me say this. As I stand there, all you're going to get is Jesus. I may not be perfect every time. I may not be perfect every time. As a matter of fact, I'm not perfect every time. I know that. But I serve a perfect God who is perfect and has never failed me through the successes and the downfalls that my job has to offer. Through family stuff. How many of y'all got some family stuff going on? We all do. We all got someone who's crazy. And if you didn't raise your hand, you're the crazy one. So get right. You see, right now we're going to have the opportunity, as the prayer team joins us on the sides, there's going to be prayer on the sides of the stages, but I want to say this to you. If y'all would just bow your heads with me for a second. Some of y'all say, man, Derek, I heard you talk about Jesus today, and he was doing something in my heart. He started doing things. He started talking to me on the inside. I've never felt that before. It's kind of weird. You see, I'm going to tell you this. Jesus was a real person. Even people that are atheists know that he was actually a real person. He was real. The thing that separates Christians is that he's our Savior. We believe that he is one part of the Trinity. God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Jesus lived a perfect, blameless life on this earth. Sinless. Perfect. Took a beating that you and I deserve for our sins, with the mistakes that we made. He took that beating for us and thought that we were worth it. And as he hung on the cross and as he died, he did that for you and me. And 3 days later, he rose again and is alive and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He is alive now. We serve a living God who wants to talk to you every single day. He wants to walk with you every single day. It is a simple decision to make, but it is not easy to follow Jesus, especially in this area. If you heard that for the first time, or maybe you heard it for the millionth time, but you want to rededicate your life, or you want to dedicate your life to Jesus, would you just raise your hand? I just want you to raise your hand.